So let's look at this button. It has a glass cover that we need to click it to open and show the actual button inside. And if you change your mind, you can click it again to close it. This means we have to keep track of the close and open state. In previous tutorial, I used a JavaScript to add and remove the class. This works fine, but if you are looking for a pure CSS approach, then we'll need to find another way. In this tutorial, we will show you the CSS checkbox hack and turn it into the button we can track the state. Ready? Let's check it out. Here's the basic checkbox. You will see that it's not necessary to click at the box in order to mark it. You can also click the label and it will work just the same. So the trick is, if we hide the box, then add a CSS to style the label, it will look and work the same as button. But this time we will be able to keep track the click state from the checkbox. So let's start with adding hidden attribute to the input tag. This will hide the box completely and leave us only the label. Then I will set the label size, background color, and flex layout to center the text. Also change the cursor to the pointer. Now we can keep track button state by using check status of the input. And change the background color to green. Okay, now you got the basic. Let's apply it to the button from the previous tutorial. First, let's add a hidden checkbox next to the cover wrap. Then change the cover wrap div into the label. Now let's remove all the JavaScript since we don't need it anymore. Finally, update the CSS rule. Instead of using active class to track the close and open state, we will use checkbox status. So now the button cover works the same as before except it's pure CSS now. And that's all for this tutorial, hope you guys enjoy. If you want to see more depth tips and tutorial like this, subscribe our channel for weekly update. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Bye!